Sairam students, today we'll be continuing with the lesson Bhakti Pant. Till now, let's have a quick recap. We spoke about all the Bhakti saints, starting from your Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Kabir Das, Guru Nanak, Mirabai, and Ramananda. Then we also spoke about Pandharpur, that is in Maharashtra. We spoke about Purandara Das and Kanakadasa from Karnataka. Let's take it further. Today we will be talking about important saints of Bhakti Pant and mainly in Karnataka. We will also talk about Sufi saints and the important saints of Bhakti Pant in Karnataka by name Shishunala Sharifa. Let us start with Sufi saints. The Sufi saints arrived from Persia, that is present-day Iran, and they settled in different parts of India. They are called Pir. Pir means teacher, a guru. Since they wore coarse woolen clothing called Sarv, these Muslim saints were also called as Sufis. So they got the name Sufis because of their wearing, what they were wearing, the clothing. They preached that it was possible to reach God or Allah through and through only through bhakti, that is devotion towards God. They emphasize that importance of respecting people of all the classes. So Sufi saints, just like bhakti saints, they also emphasize that all the people should be respected and treated very well. They believe that dance and music filled with devotion takes us closer to God. So they felt that with the help of dance and with the help of music, we can showcase or we can portray our devotion, our bhakti towards our God. They composed many songs in Urdu and Hindi to proclaim the importance of devotion. So Urdu also was being used for composing songs by the Sufi saints. The poetic works of Mrigavati of Kutuban and Padmavat of Malik Muhammad J.C. uphold the Sufi philosophy. These are around 12 different groups among Sufis. Four of them were very, very important. The Sufi cult, that is a Sufi movement, has presence all over the India. Bidar, Kalburgi, Vijayapur and other places of northern part of Karnataka are the important main places of Sufism. Both Hindus and Muslims take part in the religious ceremonies which were called as Urus that takes place in these centers. These rituals are very much alive and we can see even in today's generation. So till now we spoke about what are Sufi saints and the prominent Sufi saints we spoke about, and we spoke about their major important teaching and how they used to portray their devotion towards God with the help of music and dance. Let's talk about the Bhakti Pant in Karnataka, Shishunala Sharifa. He was born in Shishunala of present Shigavi Taluk of Gadag district, and he lived between 1819 to 1889. His parents' name were Imam Sahib and Hujuma. Imam named his son Muhammad Sharif as per the suggestion of a Khaji. Sharif is a Parsi word. It means a man who has ideal goals and, or you can tell, a man of worth, a man who is respected by all the people. Sharif grew up a worthy man just like his name. Imam Sahib was a disciple of Hajaresha Khadri, whose dream was to unite Hinduism and Islam. So even when Shishunala was a boy, he was taught the tenets of both the religions. He was highly influenced by Islam, by Veerashaiva and Vedic philosophies from a very, very young, tender age. Govinda Bhatt, a knowledgeable person, became his guru. He opened a school for children of Shishunala to provide education to them. His education provided a complete holistic vision of life for his students, that is the overall all-round development. Sharif, who was also very much interested to move around the people, participated in all the fairs, dramas and various other religious festivals which were arranged around Shishunala. He became the harbinger of Riyawat literature, which is a part of the Muharram celebration. So I think now by now you all know about Sufi saints, and we all know about the prominent Bhakti Panth saint by name Shishunala Sharifa. Let's quickly see the summary. Sufi saints arrived from Persia and they settled in different parts of India. They were called Pir, and they were called Sufis because of the woolen cloth what they were wearing, which was called as Suf. They preached about reaching God or Allah through love and devotion and emphasized respecting all the people. They composed songs in Urdu and Hindi, proclaiming the importance of Bhakti. Bidar, Kalburgi, Vijayapura and other places in northern Karnataka were the main centers of Sufism. Both the major religions of Hindus and Muslims take part in the religious ceremonies called the Uruz. Shishunala Sharifa was born in a place called Shishunala of present Shigavi Taluk of Gadag district in Karnataka. He was highly influenced by Islam, Veerashaiva and Vedic philosophy from a very, very small age. He became the disciple of Govind Bhatt, and he was taught the main essence of both the religions of Islam and Hinduism. He opened a school for children which emphasized on holistic vision of life. He became the harbinger of Riyawat literature, which was a part of the Muharram and which is still a part of the Muharram celebration. This is a quick small homework, children. Try doing it. Thank you.